Welcome to this instruction video. For this tutorial, I have permission from Catherine Bly to explain another blanket of her, the Secret Garden. This blanket has 9 different flower squares and a square with a key. And this is the key to the Secret Garden. I do my best to explain the squares step by step. And if you want to see the written pattern, then visit the website from Catherine. The link is below this video. The yarn that we use is Starcraft Special Double Knit, and I use a 4mm crochet hook. I hope you like this tutorial, and we're going to start. In this part we make lilies, and you need to make 16 of these squares. We start with a magic circle. And a chain 3. 1, 2, and 3. And this counts for a double crochet. In the magic circle, a double crochet. And now a chain 1. Repeat this 5 more times all the way around in the circle. 2 double crochets. 1, 2, and a chain 1. 2 double crochets. And a chain. 2 double crochets in that circle. And a chain, 2 double crochets, and a chain. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1 more to go. 2 double crochets, and a chain 1. Now we have 12 double crochets with between a chain stitch. Pull on the short tail to close the magic circle, and now we cut the yarn and make an invisible join to close this round. Open up your stitch the first chain 3 stitches. We skip those stitches, we go always to the next stitch. On the top of that double crochet we make that invisible join. Now go back to the last chain stitch you made in the top, in the middle, pull through, and this is your invisible join. Wave those tails in. In the next round we begin with a new color. Round 2 with a new color on my hook. And we begin with a standing single crochet in the first double crochet of any 2 double crochet group. 2 double crochets, and then in the first double crochet we begin with that standing single crochet. In the next stitch, a single crochet. Now we make a chain 3. 1, 2, and 3, and then skip the next chain 1 space, and then in the next 2 stitches a single crochet. 1 and 2. You have now here a little loop. Chain 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Skip the next chain 1 space, and then in the next 2 stitches a single crochet. 1, and in the next stitch 2. This is a bigger loop. Chain 3. 1, 2, 3, and skip the next chain 1 space, and in the next 2 stitches a single crochet. It goes all the way around, Now we have to make a chain 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Skip the chain 1 space and in the next 2 stitches a single crochet. Chain 3. 1, 2, 3. Skip the chain 1 space and in the next 2 stitches a single crochet. 1 and 2. And now we have to make a chain 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And now we close this round with a slip stitch in the first standing single crochet. Go in there with your hook, pick your thread up, pull through, and pull through to close this round. You have now 3 loops of 5 chain stitches and 3 loops of 3 chain stitches. Round 2, and we want to start in the middle of that chain 3 loop space. Make a slip stitch in that space. Go in with your hook, pick your thread up, pull through and pull through. Now we start in that chain 3 loop. Start with chain 3, 1, 2 and 3. And now in that chain 3 loop space we make 4 double crochets. And your first chain 3 stitches counts also for a double crochet. That makes together 5 double crochets in that same space. 4 double crochets. That's 1, 2, 3, and 4. Chain 2. 1. And 2, and go back in the same chain 3 space with another 5 double crochets. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Now under that chain 5 loop space in that chain 1 space of round 1 we make a single crochet. Fold your chain 5 stitch, chain 5 loop space to the back, and then in that chain 1 space of round 1 we make a single crochet. Now we have that chain 5 loop on the back of our work. Now skip over to the next chain 3 space and we make there a new petal. 5 double crochets in that chain 3 space. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And chain 2, 1 and 2, and go back in that same space with 5 double crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. In the next space, chain 1 space of round 1, we make a new single crochet and fold your 5 chain loop to the back. Go in that chain 1 space and make a single crochet. Skip over to the next chain 3 space and make a new petal. 5 double crochets in that space. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Chain 2, 1, and 2, and go back with 5 double crochets in that same space. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Now we have to make a single crochet in round 1 and fold your chain 5 loop to the back. and only in that chain one space of round one we make a single crochet. Now we have to make a slip stitch in the third single crochet in the beginning, 1, 2, and 3, 3, in the top of that chain 3 space, and make a slip stitch. Don't cut the yarn. In the next round we use the same color. We have now 3 petals, and on the back we have 3 times a chain 5 loop. Round 4 with the same color, and we start with a chain 1, and in that same stitch where you make that slip stitch in the previous round we make a single crochet. In the next stitch a single crochet, and in the next 2 stitches a half double crochet. That's 1, and in the next stitch 2. In the next stitch a double crochet, and now in that chain 2 space we work 2 double crochets, chain 2 and 2 double crochets. All in that same space, it's 2 double crochets, 1 and 2, chain 2, 1 and 2, and in that same space 2 double crochets. It's 1 and 2. In the next stitch, that's the first double crochet here after that chain 2 space, we work a double crochet. In the next 2 stitches a half double crochet, it's 1, and in the next stitch it's 2, and in the next 2 stitches a single crochet, it's 1 and 2. And now in the next stitch, and that should be that single crochet here, we work a slip stitch, pull through and pull through. Repeat those stitches 2 more times, and then close in that first stitch with a slip stitch. My last stitches, a double crochet, 2 half double crochet, and 2 single crochet, and our last stitch is a slip stitch in that single crochet of the previous round. And then in the first single crochet we make a slip stitch to close this round. In the next round we use the same color. Round 5, and I want to start here in the chain 1 space of round 1, and to get there we make 3 chain stitches, 1, 2, 3, and make to the back of your work in that loop of that first flower petal, go with your hook in, and then in that chain 1 space go in with your hook, and then on the back of your work we work a single crochet, and that single crochet is the first wheel stitch of this round. We work in the next chain 5 loop space, and we start there with 5 double crochets in that space. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Now chain 2, 1 and 2, and go back in that same chain 5 space with 5 double crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. For a new petal behind your work. Now in the next petal here in the round 1, in that chain 1 space, from the back to the front. We make on the back of your work a single crochet. Skip over to the next chain 5 space and we make a new petal. 5 double crochets in that space. Dus 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, chain 2 and 5 double crochets in that same space. All my yarn is splitting. So, this 2, 5. And then under the next flower petal in round 1 in that chain 1 space on the back of your work a single crochet. In the next chain 5 space a new petal, 5 double crochets in that space. Chain 2 and 5 double crochets. And now in the next chain 1 space we made in the beginning a single crochet and in that single crochet we make a slip stitch on the top of that single crochet and slip stitch to close this round. And don't cut the yarn, we use the same color in the next round. Round 6. And now in the back petals here we make in the next 2 stitches a single crochet. Spun, go to the next stitch, 2. In the next 2 stitches a half double crochet. This 1. And in the next stitch 2. And in the next stitch a double crochet. And now in that chain 2 space we work 2 double crochets. This 1. And 2. Chain 2. And 2 double crochets in that same chain 2 space. This 1. And 2. In the next stitch, and that's the first double crochet after that chain 2 space and double crochet, and in the next 2 stitches a half double crochet. It's 1 and in the next stitch 2. In the next 2 stitches a single crochet. It's 1 and 2, and then in the next stitch, and that's the in the top of that single crochet of the previous round, we make a slip stitch. Now you have a petal on the back. In the next leaf on the back of your work, we make in the next 2 stitches a single crochet. In the next 2 stitches a half double crochet. And in the next stitch a double crochet. In the next chain 2 space 2 doubles. Chain 2 and 2 doubles. It's 1 and 2. In the next stitch a double. In the next 2 stitches a half double. It's 1 and 2. And in the next 2 stitches a single crochet. It's 1 and 2 and then in the next stitch, and that is on the top of that single crochet, we make a slip stitch. Repeat all the stitches in the last petal and then we make an invisible join in the beginning. I'm done with all the stitches and I cut the yarn to make that invisible join. We skip the first slip stitch and we go to the next stitch. from the front to the back, pull through, and then the last single crochet that you make in the top, and this is your invisible join, and wave that thread in on the back of your work. New color in round 7, and we start in a petal on the front of your work. In that chain 2 space with a standing single crochet. In that same space, 2 single crochets, 1 and 2. And now we work in all the next stitches only in the back loop of our stitch. This is the next stitch, and this is the whole stitch. You have here a V on the top of that stitch, and that's the whole stitch. And this is the front loop of that stitch, and this is the back loop of that stitch, and only in the back loop of all those stitches we're going to work. Only in the back loop. In the next 2 stitches we work only in the back loop a half double crochet. Yarn over and go to the top of that stitch, and then in the back loop we work a half double crochet. In the next stitch, only in the back loop, a half double crochet. In the next 2 stitches, a double crochet only in the back loop. So double crochet. And in the next stitch, only in the back loop of that stitch, we work a double crochet. We work also a double crochet in the next stitch of that petal on the front, but also in a stitch of the petal of the back of your work. And that stitch we make in the 5th stitch counting from that chain 2 space. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, and this is the stitch number 5, and only in that back loop. And I pull that loop a little bit up that you see which loop I mean. Counts 5 stitches, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Yarn over and go to the next stitch of that leaf on the top of your work, only in the back loop, and pick up that loop. And then go back to the leaf on the back of your work in that 5th stitch counting from that chain 2. Pick up that loop, pick up your thread, pull through, and then make a double crochet. Now you make 2 petals together. We go further on the petal on the back of your work, and in the next 2 stitches, only in the back loop, we work a double crochet. This is 1, go to the next stitch, only in the back loop, and double crochet, 2. In the next 2 stitches, only in the back loop, and half double crochet. This is 1, and in the next stitch, only in the back loop, 2. And now in that chain 2 space, we work 3 single crochets in that space. It's 1, 2, and 3. In the next 2 stitches, only in the back loop, a half double crochet. It's 1, and in the next stitch, 2. In the next 2 stitches, a double crochet only in the back loop, 1 and 2, and in the next stitch we work also a double crochet, but also in that leaf on the top of your work. And then in the fifth stitch, count from that chain 2 space. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 is this stitch here. We make in that 2 petals together a double crochet. Pick up your yarn of that loop and that loop in the back of your work from 2 petals and make that double crochet . Now you work also 2 petals together. We go further with the petal of the front of your work in the next 2 stitches, only in the back loop, and double crochet. It's 1, and in the next stitch, 2, and in the next 2 stitches, only in the back loop, and half double crochet. And now 3 double of 3 single crochets in that chain 2 space. It's 1, 2, and 3. Now repeat all those stitches after that chain, after that 3 single crochets. Repeat all the stitches 2 more times and then make a slip stitch in the first standing single crochet. Round 8, and we start with a chain 1, and in that same space where you make that slip stitch, a single crochet. In the next 3 stitches, a single crochet. It's 1, 2, and 3. In the next 2 stitches, a half double crochet. It's 1 and 2. In the next 3 stitches, a double crochet. 1, 2, and 3. In the next 2 stitches, a half double crochet. It's 1, and in the next 2. And now in the next 5 stitches, a single crochet. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Now repeat all the stitches after that. 4 single crochets here, all the stitches all the way around, and make an invisible join in the beginning. I start my last repeat of this round. In the next 2 stitches a half double, in the next 3 stitches a double, in the next 2 stitches a half double. And now here's the beginning of our round, and in the beginning we work 4 single crochets. It must be 5. We have now 1 stitch over here, and in that last stitch we make now 1 single crochet, and that makes 5 single crochets together. Now we cut the yarn and open up our stitch. And make that invisible join in the second stitch, not in the first stitch, but in the second stitch. Go back to your last single crochet on the top, pull through. This is what we have now. We start with a new color in round 9, and we start counting in those stitches. Here is your back petal, and this is the front petal, and between the back and the front petal we have here 3 double crochets. We skip those 3 double crochets. The next 2 stitches are 2 half double crochets, and we skip also that 2 half double crochets. And in the next stitch, and that's the first single crochet of that 5 single crochets, we start in that stitch with a standing half double crochet. In the next 2 stitches, a double crochet. That's 1, and in the next stitch, 2. Now we skip the next 2 stitches and work, and then in the next stitch, a corner. And in that corner stitch, we make 4 treble crochets, chain 2, and 4 treble crochets. Yarn twice over for a double crochet and skip the next 2 stitches and work in the next stitch 4 treble crochets. Yarn over, pull through 2, yarn over, pull through 2, yarn over, pull through 2 for a double. Twice over and go back in that same stitch and work another 3 double crochets and treble crochets in that stitch. 3 and 4 trebles in that same stitch. Chain 2 and now go back in that same stitch with another 4 treble crochets. That's 1 2 4. This is your first corner of your square. Skip the next 2 stitches and then work in the next 2 stitches and double crochet. Skip 2 stitches in the next stitch and double crochet, and in the next stitch and double crochet, and in the next stitch and half double crochet. Now in the next 7 stitches a single crochet. This is 1, go to the next stitch, 2, and in the next 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. In the next stitch a half double crochet, and in the next 2 stitches a double crochet. This is 1, and in the next stitch 2. Skip the next 2 stitches and then in the next stitch we work another corner. Twice over, then skip the next 2 stitches and then in the next stitch we make that new corner with 4 treble crochets. That's 1, 2, 3 and 4, chain 2 and 4 trebles in that same stitch. That's 1, 2, 3 and 4. And this is the same corner than the first corner. Repeat all the stitches after the corner here, all the way around, and then make an invisible join to in the beginning. Round 10 with a new color on the hook, and we begin in a chain 2 corner space with a standing half double crochet in that space. In that same space, a half double crochet, chain 2, 1 and 2, and 2 more half double crochets in that same corner space. It's 1 and 2 for a new corner. Around the next 4 treble stitches we make a back post double crochet. yarn over and go to that first treble stitch around that stitch, and then on the back we make that double crochet. So back post double crochet. In the next stitch, around that treble, and then on the back make that double crochet. It's two, three, and in the next that's four back post double crochets. On the next 13 stitches we work a single crochet. Let's go to the next stitch and make a single crochet, and that's the first of 13. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, and 13. On the next 4 treble stitches we work a back post double crochet. So round that next treble, on the back and double crochet. It's 1, go to the next. It's 2 back post double crochet. That's 3 and 4. Now in that corner space we work 2 half double crochets. It's 1 and 2, chain 2 and 2 half double crochets in that same space. It's 1 and 2. Now repeat all those stitches after that corner here. All those stitches 3 more times and make a slip stitch in your first standing half double crochet. Round 11, and we start with the same color with a chain 1, and then in the stitch, same stitch where you make that slip stitch in the previous round, we make a single crochet in the next stitch, and that's the last stitch for that chain 2 corner space, also a single crochet. In that corner space we make a new corner, 2 single crochets. It's 1 and 2, chain 2, 1 and 2, and go back in that same space with 2 more single crochets. 1 and 2 for your new corner. Now skip the next stitch, and that's that hidden stitch here after that corner. That little stitch here, we skip those stitch, and then in the next stitch we work a single crochet, and that's the first of 24 single crochets. In every stitch to the next corner a single crochet, 24 in total. It's number 2, and go to the next stitch, 3, 4, 5, also to the next corner, 24 in total. And now in the last stitch for the corner, that's stitch number 24. In that corner space we make a new corner, 2 single crochets, chain 2 and 2 single crochets in that same space. Now repeat all the stitches after the first corner here, all the way around, and make a slip stitch in the first single crochet. I'm done with all the stitches all the way around, and then on the end we make 22 single crochets. In the beginning we work here 2 single crochets, and that makes 24 single crochets together. And then we make a slip stitch in the beginning in the first single crochet, on the top a slip stitch. In the next round we use the same color, and that's also the last round of this square. round 12 and we start with the same color with and chain 1 and then in the same stitch, yeah, under that slip stitch we work a back post single crochet. Go around that stitch and make on the back a single crochet. On the next 3 stitches for that corner space we work also in that 3 stitches and back post single crochet. So round those stitch, a single crochet, and then on the third for the corner and back post single crochet, and on the fourth stitch for the corner and back post single crochet. Now in that chain 2 corner space we make a new corner with 3 single crochets in that same space. 1, 2, and 3 for that new corner. And now we make on the next 28 stitches, and that brings you to the next corner. In every stitch we make a back post single crochet, and in corner space here we start around that first single crochet, that's your first stitch, with a standing with a back post single crochet, and that's the stitches are really tiny, can be hard to work in it. It's 2, and every stitch it's 3 and back post single crochet, 4, 28 stitches in total. 5, and my last stitch, number 28. And now in that chain 2 corner space, a new corner from 3 single crochets. 1, 2, and 3. Repeat all those stitches all the way around, and then we make in the beginning here our last invisible join, and then we're done. It's 21, 22, 23, and 24, and it must be 28 stitches in total. We made 4 single crochets in the beginning, that's 28 together. Now we cut the yarn and open up that stitch, and we make our last invisible join of this square. We skip the first single crochet, we go to the next stitch, around that first stitch we're working, around that first stitch, back to the last back post single crochet on the top, pull through. And now on the back we make a little knot, and wave that tail in. Now you have to make 16 of these squares in total. For now, thank you for watching and see you next time. Bye!